Well, I would advise the ministries to provide weekly reports and post them on the government websites of their accomplishments or anything they've done that has transpired into the week in their ministry. That said, though, that is anything that will not be of national security. The biggest challenges definitely is unemployment and crime, and I think that they definitely go hand in hand. We need to just step up to the plate and do what we got to do to eradicate crime, and I think providing jobs should be able to suffice both. If we were to try to Caymanize as many posts as possible and, you know, stop relying on outsourcing, for example, I think that would help a lot in this situation. Well, an independent candidate definitely will be able to voice the opinions of the people directly without having to go to a party to get their approval and without having to listen to the leader of a party. So, in my opinion, that's why I'm independent, because I want to be able to exercise my right as an independent candidate and to speak on behalf of my people. Well, I would say that the people of East End are very vigilant, and they know that I did not just come out 6 months prior to an election to try to show myself up. First of all, I've been very active in the community. I live in the community. I know what time of day it is of what's going on. For example, today is a classical example. Last night there was a fire in a home. I was the first on the scene in the morning after I realized, and that is out of the two candidates that are competing for the seat. So living in the district, I would say to anybody, not only in East End, is a major thing as a candidate. I do not believe in any candidate whatsoever that they should be able to run in any district that they don't live in, because you don't know exactly what's going on daily